Hi, I'm Jason Sterling, and this is the Sim Sunday Show, still called the Sim Sunday Show as of right now. I don't know. I'm not really in love with that name. I might change it, because I'm just not really in love with it. But I am in love. I am in love with The Sims, and this was The Sims' 20th anniversary this week. It was on February the 4th, and what can I say? What can I say about that day? I mean, it was a day of the week. It was a day of the week, and it was a day of the week that ended with Y, as in... Why? Why did that happen? I don't know. For those of us with the patio stuff already, you know, Perfect Patio stuff pack, we got about a dozen skins for a hot tub. And for those without the pack, you know, you got the hot tub itself. So, and a couple of bug fixes, and that was about it. That was really about it. There wasn't a bunch of up play, I didn't feel like, or a bunch of excitement. I mean, you had, the typical story, like, share your memories with us, you know, sort of stuff. But it really wasn't very exciting. It fell flat. It fell very flat. And, you know, I was surprised. I personally was surprised. I really loved the game, and I had built up sort of a lot of expectation for this anniversary, for this event. And... not only because of my love of the game, but because it is such an iconic sort of fixture in the world. And, you know, by iconic, I mean, you know, people recognize it. Even when they don't play it, even when they haven't played it, you know, and they're not involved with it, they still kind of recognize it. It's kind of like, what's this? Oh, that's a Coke. Oh, that's Mickey Mouse. Oh, that's The Sims. Oh, that's Satan. I mean, everybody recognizes it for what it is. So... I was surprised for that reason too, that, it felt like the ball was kind of dropped and like marketing kind of missed a real opportunity to play this into some real excitement and exuberance to kind of really, they did get people fired up. I was going to say kind of really get people fired up. They did get people fired up. They were really, really fired up. And, you know, I want to say about marketing, I tried a lot of different things in college, and not all of them involved me in a state of undress. Not, you know, all of them. But marketing did. And even though I met a lot of marketing people then, and I know a lot about marketing, I do feel like the people at Maxis are probably pretty nice. You know, I feel like they're probably still pretty nice, despite the fact that I have known a lot of marketing people. I'm going to give them the benefit of the doubt that they're pretty nice and basically, as a general rule, sober. I am going to say that. But at the same time, how the hell hard is it to throw a party? I mean, they really didn't even have to build up expectation with this. I mean, the fact of the matter is, people were already excited. People were already expecting stuff. It was that part. That's a hard part. And that was like totally already there. And it still just didn't happen. And it's funny. Like I said, I was really disappointed. And I'll get into that more here in a second. But I... felt like it was, I took a poll. Let me just start with that. I took a poll, and the poll showed that about 60% of the people expected a either large or small celebration tied to a large patch. 60% is a lot. That's a lot of people. That's essentially that 60% of your base players that were disappointed. So, you know, 60% of the release by this poll, like I said last time, it's not scientific, I'm not a scientist, blah, blah, blah. But 60% of the people following me, and I'm by general, and the people that follow me in general, are usually pretty well satisfied. I mean, I don't think we're real hardcore with this game as far as our expectations. I don't think that we are always bitching about it or always upset. So 60%, you know, we're essentially disappointed. Of a group that's generally pretty happy. That's what I mean by that. You had another 20% that felt like, well, they were expecting kind of a small mention and a small patch. And I think they were probably pretty happy. I think they were probably pretty satisfied with it. That's basically what we got. You know, we got a small patch, got some sort of mentions here or there. And also, I noticed, too, that like some of the studios appeared to be maybe having parties or something. I don't know. There were a few pictures put out like that. And, you know, I mean... I hope they had fun. I hope they did. A lot of other people didn't. I didn't. Oh my gosh. The internet was in turmoil. But you had the last 20% of the people who basically expected nothing. That was the most interesting, I felt, turn on that poll was 60% expected nothing. And they were broken into basically like three groups of why they expected nothing. You had the people that just didn't think it was a big deal. You know, it just wasn't any big deal to them. They didn't think it was a big deal, so they didn't expect anything. And that's reasonable. I mean, I get that. Some people are not going to think that. Some people, the game's not very important to them either. You know, it's something they play and it's kind of fun, but it's not really important. So, you know, it's not going to be that big a deal. And they were probably satisfied, too. Then you had the people, I think, that were just kind of... I was kind of a keeping the peace type of response. Like, okay, well, I wasn't expecting anything. We got this, and it's nice, and it's fine. You know, so that I think they kind of knew it was the anniversary is going on, but okay, you know, so whatever we get is what we get, and so you had that group. But I felt like the largest part of the group who expected nothing because they had, this is what some people said, well, I've just come to the point where I realize EA is just not going to do anything for us. And by EA, a Maxis, you know, isn't going to do anything for us. They don't care. And I think that's really sad. I think that's really unfortunate. I do. And I really think so because A, this event reinforced that idea with them. This event really, this non-event really, reinforced with them that feeling. And B, it took some other people that were probably waffling and pushed them over to that category. Of, okay, yeah, we just shouldn't have any expectations at all. We shouldn't have any expectations of anything exciting, you know, at all. And so I think that that's the unfortunate part here, and that's where the biggest loser in this event comes from, and it's EA itself. EA had a chance to really, really fire this up and really gear up this event and generate a ton of positive press. Positive responses. No, you are not going to make everybody happy. You're not. Not with 40 million players, you're not. You're sure not. But you had a chance to, with the vast majority of people, generate this great positive press and a whole lot of future goodwill. And that's something you really can't buy. I don't care how many ads you do. I don't care how many banners you have. I don't care how many little cars drive around the city of Paris. You cannot buy goodwill with anything but just positive good acts. So, that's really why I feel the biggest loser was. Because at the end of the day, for your average player, for even for myself, it was a disappointment. It was definitely a disappointment. But we're going to get over it. We've gotten over plenty of disappointments in the past. And, you know, we've gotten over lots of marketing gaffes. Nobody is going to ever forget the executive level dance party that launched Get Together. Nobody's ever going to forget that. And I'm going to say real quick. I'm going to say, too. I'm going to editorialize here a little bit as if that's not what I'm doing. I do admire Rachel Franklin. I think that she did, a great job with what she had to work with a community and a game back when she was in charge of The Sims 4. I think she did a great job, and I really think, I admire her for getting up on stage. It takes a lot of courage. It takes a lot of courage to get on stage in front of anybody for any reason, let alone dance. It does. It takes a lot of courage or a lot of alcohol or a lot of alcohol. That's the other thing. Courage and alcohol, which are kind of the same thing, but it takes a lot of that. And because, you know, I've been on stage lots like that dancing, lots, in reference at various stages of undress. But, you know, every time I did it, I'd been drinking. So, you know, and I don't think she was drinking. I don't think that Rachel, I don't think she had a single drink before she went on stage. Now, maybe afterwards, because I would have. If I got on stage and had that launch and then read Twitter, yeah, I would have drank a fifth of anything. I don't care. Rubbing alcohol, yeah, sure, that's fine. Whatever, just give me something. So anyway, where was I? Yeah, we've suffered this before. We've gone through disappointments. We have gone through marketing gaffes before. I'm going to go through plenty of them in the future. And for myself, yes, I was disappointed. I was very disappointed. I felt let down. And I even felt a little foolish for expecting it. Like, you know, expecting it was a big deal and was going to be a big deal. And then quite obviously, you know, it wasn't. It wasn't important. That's the thing. This thing I was kind of taking away from it was, okay, well, I guess it wasn't as important as I thought it was going to be. And then I remembered, it is important. It's important to me. And at the end of the day, that's what really mattered, was that it was important to me. And I really didn't need anyone else to celebrate. And I really didn't need anyone else to make it important for it to continue to be important to me. And to a lot of us. A lot of us, you know, we pulled ourselves together and we remembered, remembered all of the good times, all of the better times, and in the end we had a good day, and that was the important thing at the end of the day, was it was important to me, and that's all that really mattered, that's all really need to be important to. So, next week we are going to look at the EA Game Changers program. We're going to look at some of the myths, I think, about the program, and then some of the realities about the program, and also my experiences in it as a small creator. Not a large creator. There's a lot of small creators in the program, and I'm gonna look at my experiences and talk about that a little bit. And so I look forward to seeing you then. I hope that you will tune in. In the meantime, hey, join the crew of the Airship Cascadian. Hit like, subscribe, and follow me on Twitter. And thanks for watching.